Tank Davis is gonna fight
Frank Martin.
Frank Martin.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you think about that fight?
I say Tank's putting him to sleep.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Early knockdown? Early knockout?
Not early, maybe later into the fight. About, I'm gonna say sixth in line, one of them.
Okay.
Rounds. But he's definitely gonna, he's gonna pick that shot and put him down just like he did Rowley.
Nice. Oh, speaking of Rowley, what do you think about, tell me your take on the Pitbull and Rowley.
I really had high expectations for Rowley going into this fight. I thought he was, just the way he was building it up, I thought he was gonna really do something. I was still going for Pitbull, but I'm like, man, I'm giving that chance to Rowley. Just to, like, touch him right or do something, put him down. But after that first round, I was like, nah, Rowley, what are you doing? I mean, Pitbull's a strong, strong fighter, so that I understand. But I don't know what happened to him that night. I know he trained hard for that fight, so.
Do you think Rowley can come back and be world champion at that weight class?
At 140, if he chooses the right opponents, yeah, he can. But if he chooses, like, the tough opponents, like the big champions at 140, nah.
So you don't think he beats Teo, no. Haney, no. Tank?
No.
So none of the top guys at 140, you don't think Rowley beats them? Okay. What about a rematch? Because I think there might be a possible rematch on that fight.
With him and who?
With Pitbull.
Same thing happens.
Same thing happens?
Yeah.
You don't think Rowley could make any adjustments and change the outcome?
I mean, he could really try to, like, box him, but that ain't his style. And he pulls out with his hands down and tries to pull. And he ain't gonna change that. He always does that every fight. That's how he got caught. Boom.
Okay. We also got the Canelo fight coming up.
Yeah.
Tell me what you think about that. Who you like? And
Canelo's one of my favorite fighters as well. So.
Okay.
But I feel like if he fights like the old style he used to fight, catching in combination, not just one power shot at a time, moving his head, he's in an easy night for him. But if he goes in there trying to just dog Munguia one punch at a time, Munguia's going to give him a hard fight. So, but Canelo's one of my favorite fights.
Okay.
So I'm going with Canelo.
You going by Canelo, what, decision, knockout?
I could see a knockout happening, but decision for sure.
Decision for sure. Now, Canelo's been criticized a lot for supposedly ducking Benavidez. Okay. Tell me what your opinion on that is. Do you think Canelo's ducking? Or do you think it's just a way to build up the fight where he can possibly fight him in November?
Yeah. I feel like people think he's ducking him, but he's not. He's just waiting on the right time to choose him, when to fight, and you know, build that fight up. I don't think he's ducking him. People may think he's ducking him, but Canelo ain't scared of nobody.
Okay.
He proved that already. They say he was scared of Triple G, and you see what he did to Triple G. Second fight and third fight. First fight was close, yes. It could have went either way, but second fight, he proved that he's the top dog.
So, with that being said, do you think Benavidez beats Canelo if they were to fight in November? Possibly.
No, I can't go against Canelo. I really want, like, I like Benavidez too, but if Canelo just, if he's smart and he lets his hands go and uses his defense, easy. I think he beats Benavidez because Benavidez ain't really got too much defense. You know he got power though for sure, and he's strong and he's gonna try to put his weight on you and make you tired, but I'm still going with Canelo, for sure.
You're still going with Canelo?
Yeah.
Aside from the fact that maybe people might think that Canelo's going on a decline and Benavidez coming up.
I don't think he's going on a decline. He's just, I mean, yeah, he's using just power mainly now, but he's kind of his last few fights, he's been trying going back to don't letting his hands go and moving his head and stuff. So I don't think he's on a decline, but in a few years, yeah, he probably will. That's when he'll be done.
Well, but people,
he's proved himself, and he is one of the best to ever box.
Okay. Well, the only reason why some people might say that Canelo's going on a decline is just maybe because he's been getting hit more, right? But maybe considering the fact of his opponents, maybe they don't got that power, right? He fought Caleb Plant, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, he fought some other fighters where, you know, Canelo did get hit, you know? Yeah. So maybe at Canelo's age, you know, it's something as people would question as whether Canelo still has that movement still.
I mean, it's boxing, you're gonna get hit. There's no way around it. You're fighting, so you're gonna get hit. But he's kind of been declining on his defense. But like you said, the people he's fighting haven't really had too much power. If he knew they had power, I'm pretty sure he would make a miss. And I feel like he's going back to that, so it's gonna be good for him.
So in other words, do you think Canelo will go back to his boxing abilities where he's going to fine-tune his movements if he were to fight Benavidez? Because Benavidez does have more pop in his punches.
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay. All right. Perfect. Which dream fight are you looking forward? Like, you know, as far as like your favorite fighters, you know, what fight are you looking forward to see happening by the end of the year or, you know?
I for sure want to see the Canelo Benavidez fight.
Okay.
Let me think. Who else?
Anthony Joshua, Tyson Fury.
Yeah, I'm not too high on that fight, but yeah, I would like to see that fight. I want to see Tank versus Shakur.
Tank versus Shakur.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Shakur versus Haney.
And Shakur versus Haney.
Yeah. Those fights.
Right. Who do you got? Who do you think will win?
It's gonna be hard to choose between Tank and Shakur. I like both of them, and I know Shakur. He's good. He's real good.
Okay.
And I got a few rounds in with him as well.
Oh, so you did spar with Shakur?
Yeah. He was working with everybody in the gym, so.
Nice.
I hopped in there, got experience.
Okay.
Real smart fighter. Great learning experience.
What's something that you learned from sparring Shakur about that? What's something that you took on where, you know, you're probably, like, using it to your craft now?
Just the smartness and being able to set up his opponents and, you know, his timing, his correct distance. He's very hard to hit him. You just make a little slight movement and you're missing. So I was trying to pick up on that and stay sharp just like him.
And when was the last time that you had sparred against Shakur?
It's been a while, probably like 2022.
Okay, so a couple years ago. I remember talking to Davies, you know, he did say that he wanted to give you 6 fights.
Yeah, 4 to 6 fights a year.
Exactly. 4 to 6 fights a year.
Yep, staying active, staying mentally in the gym, mentally strong.
Okay. You know, we got word from Cameron Davis also. Bernard Hopkins is going to be there.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so does that mean...
The executioner.
Yeah, the executioner. Does that mean we're expecting, you know...
I'm going to put on a show. I'm going to show out and I'm going to show them who I am. Make him remember my name.
Nice, nice. Yeah. I mean, considering the fact that you've been sparring all over Houston, you know, Shakur is there. Darius is there. Nice. You know, all right, so then everybody's, so pretty much all the Houston fighters pretty much know who you are, right? As far as Darius, Kid Austin.
Kid Austin.
Did you spar with Kid Austin as well?
Yeah, his last camp, a few weeks out from his fight.
Okay.
I helped him put a few rounds.
Nice. What do you think about Kid Austin, by the way, as far as him being in that weight division? Do you think he's a future star or what?
He's very, He's very good. I mean, he has he's very strong. As you can see, all his fights, he's dropping people, putting them down. So I believe he could be a world champion one day. So he just has to stay disciplined and stay in the gym.
He did say that Shakur Twitterson is dodging him. So tell me your take on that. You know, do you think Shakur is dodging Kid Austin or what? No, he's not. Now, who do you think will win that fight? Kid Austin, Shakur?
I'm not gonna say.
You're not gonna say?
I'm not gonna say.
Is that due to the fact that because you spar both of them or what?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm cool with both of them, so.
Okay.
I'm not gonna speak on that one.
You're not gonna speak on that one?
Yeah.
Off camera?
Off camera.
All right, man. Well, definitely looking forward to see you tomorrow, man. Putting up on a good show. Tell us your IG, man. So
you can follow me at team_Arredondo23.
Perfect, brother. See you tomorrow. What's going on, Fabian?
What's up?
So made weight, we ate good.
Yeah.
So you know, looking forward to tomorrow, put on the show.
Yeah, more than ready.
Nice, nice.
Well, yeah. All
right. So we got some big fights coming up.
Yeah.
Devin Haney. Ryan Garcia.
Yeah.
Tell me what you think about that fight, man.
So I see Ryan Garcia. He's like, I don't know if he's what's going on with him. I don't know. I just really don't know. He's like posting crazy stuff. And Haney ain't really posting too much. He's just working. So, you know, I'm going to have to go Haney on this one because he seems focused. I'm pretty sure Ryan's training hard and stuff, but he has a lot of different other things going on between himself.
So do you think Ryan is trolling too much, or is it him just probably his way of promoting the fight, or do you think there's something more to that than just that?
I think it's both. I think he's doing too much and he's trying too hard to, you know, go through the promoting the fight, but he's just doing too much, like too much goofing around and stuff. He needs to focus on the fight because he has a big task ahead of him, because Haney ain't no slouch and it's gonna be a tough night for him.
So in other words, you think he's just pouring more energy outside the ring than he's supposed to be pouring inside camp?
Yeah, for sure. He's not too focused into like training, and I mean, I'm pretty sure he's focused, but he's just overdoing it, you know. He's like, he should just be focused on the fight and not all the other things going on. After the fight, do whatever you want, post whatever you want, but right now you should just be dialed in and going hard.
And then you said you like Devin, right?
Yeah, I like Devin Haney, but I want him to get beat one day. I'm pretty sure he's gonna get beat, like, by someone pretty good. He's ducking Shakur for sure.
Oh, you think so? You think Devin is ducking Shakur?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay.
For sure.
And but you also had mentioned that Devin, that Haney is gonna beat Ryan. Do you have any, like, what, decision, knockout, what?
I feel like he can stop Ryan, but I mean, Ryan's tough, so we'll see. I'm pretty sure he's gonna win for sure. In my opinion, this is a matter of how he's gonna win.
Well, let's also not forget that Ryan did get dropped by Tank Davis on the body.
But Tank, he's a very strong fighter, and I'm pretty sure Haney's very strong too, but just he ain't as strong as Tank. He got that pop like him.
So something tells me you like Tank more than anybody else in that division.
Tank's one of my favorite fighters.
Oh, Tank's one of your favorite fighters. Okay. So now, so you think, okay, so let's just, in scenario-wise, Haney beats Ryan, right?
Yeah.
Do you think Haney beats Teofimo?
That's a good fight, but Teofimo, when he's on point, and he's strong. Teofimo's strong, too. And if he touches him right, he might be able to put him down. I mean, Haney's a really good boxer, don't get me wrong, but Lopez is strong, and he's a smart fighter, too, and he could play around with you, set you up. So I really like Teofimo, too. I met him once when he fought in Corpus a long time ago, I think about 2017. It was before anybody knew him, and we were just sitting around talking to each other, just like a little group, just talking to each other normal, and looking up now.
Nice. So basically, the one fighter that you think is going to dominate 140 is Tank Davis?
Well, Tank Davis fights at 135.
135.
So I think he dominates 135 and 130, but 140 might be too big for him, so I don't think so.
You think 140 is too big for Tank?
Yeah, I mean, Tank got power, but those guys are pretty big too, and he's too small for that weight, in my opinion.
Okay. Well, he did also fight Barrios at 140.
Yeah, but Barrios wasn't like the best at that weight.
Okay. All right. And,
I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.